Naver, Wikipedia article audio. 119. History. Junior Naver. Naver Wetuan. Naver Cafe. Naver Blog. Naver TV Cast. Knowledge in. Naver Language Dictionary. Naver Encyclopedia. Naver IPA is a South Korean online platform operated by Naver Corporation. It debuted in 1999 as the first web portal in Korea to develop and use its own search engine. It was also the world's first operator to introduce the comprehensive search feature, which compiles search results from various categories and presents them in a single page. Naver has since added a multitude of new services ranging from basic features such as email and news to the world's first online Q&A platform Knowledge In. As of September 2017, the search engine handled 74.7% of all web searches in South Korea and had 42 million enrolled users. More than 25 million Koreans have Naver as the start page on their default browser, and the mobile application has 28 million daily visitors. Naver is also constantly referred to as the Google of South Korea. Naver was created in June 1999 as the first South Korean portal website with a self-developed search engine. In August 2000, Naver began the comprehensive search service, which allows users to get a variety of results from a search query on a single page, organized by type, including blogs, websites, images, cafes, etc. This was 5 years before Google launched a similar offer with its universal search function. In the early days of Naver's operation, there was a relative dearth of web pages available in the Korean language. To fill this void, Naver became an early pioneer in user-generated content through the creation of the Knowledge In service in 2002. In Knowledge In, users can pose questions on any subject and select among answers provided by other users, awarding points to the users who gives the best answers. Knowledge In was launched 3 years before Yahoo launched its similar Yahoo Answers service, and now possesses a database of over 200 million answers. Over the years, Naver has continued to expand its services. It launched its webcomic service Wetoon in 2004 and its personal blog service in 2005. From 2005 to 2007, Naver expanded its multimedia search services, including music and video search as well as mobile search. Junior Naver, also known as Juniver, is a portal website for children considered similar to Yahooligans. Junior Naver offers services such as avatars, educational content, quizzes, videos, Q&A, and a homework helper. Junior Naver utilizes a panel of experts and educators to filter out harmful content in order to ensure a safe internet environment for children. Ever since its competitors Dom Kids and Yahoo Kids have closed down, Junior Naver is the only children's portal site operating in Korea. Naver Wetoon is a webcomic platform where users have free access to a variety of wetoons created by professional artists. They can also pay publishers to view comic books and genre fiction contents online. Naver also has a challenge section which allows amateurs to post and promote their own works. Naver Cafe is a service that allows Naver users to create their own internet communities. There were 10.5 million cafes running as of May 2017. Naver Blog started with the name Paper in June 2003, and evolved to Blog in October 2003. It had 23 million users as of April 2016. Naver TV Cast is a web broadcast network which mainly provides web dramas distributed by Naver. Knowledge In, formerly Knowledge Search, is an online Q&A platform launched in October 2002. The tool allows users to ask any question and to receive answers from other users. Knowledge In was an early example of harnessing user-generated content to expand the amount of information available on the web, particularly in the Korean language. Bradley Horowitz, Vice President of Product Strategy at Yahoo, has cited Knowledge In as the inspiration for Yahoo Answers, which was launched 3 years after Naver introduced the original service. Knowledge In has several categories. Naver Dictionary supports 34 languages, including English, Korean, Chinese, Chinese characters, Japanese, Global Communication, Vietnamese, Uzbek, Indonesian, Thai, Arabic, Cambodian, Tamil, Mongolian, Hindi, Persian, Nepali, Swahili, French, German, Spanish, Russian, Italian, Latin, Portuguese, Turkish, Georgian, Albanian, Ukrainian, Romanian, Dutch, Swedish, Hungarian, Polish, and Czech as of May 2017. Handwriting recognition is supported in Japanese and Chinese. In 2016, Naver announced that it would invest 10 billion won for the development of language dictionaries. Naver Encyclopedia consists of a professional database with over 3 million entries from many different encyclopedias. Knowledge Q&A allows general questions about anything, and has a lot of subcategories within itself: education, academy, computer communication, games, entertainment, art, life, health, society, politics, economy, travel, sports, leisure, shopping. Local Q&A allows people to ask for local information such as good restaurants, cheap stores, real estate, etc. Agony Q&A, for people seeking advice on relationships, love, career, and sex. While other categories usually provide factual answers, Agony Q&A tends to return more opinionated responses. Juniver Q&A, questions for children.